Alright, so we're on the road. We're headed to Monastery Lake today, up in Pecos. Pecos River runs right beside it, I think. I think it flows in, it flows out. We're gonna go catch some trout today. I just stopped the. It's still summertime, but it's cooler up there. I guess the water stays cold enough for the trout. About an hour and a half coming out of Albuquerque.
The camera jumped around a little bit there. Anyway, we're here. That didn't take too long, right? let's gear up and go fishing. All right, so here we are, just walking up to the lake. Got some history, some rules. There's even a quick scan number. That's kind of cool. No ice fishing. I don't think we have to worry about that one. No littering. There you go. Pick up your trash. Pick up your trash. Walk down to the lake. It's just through the trees here. You can see it out there. Oh, it's a busy day down here. Most people I've ever seen down here is about 3 or 4. But I came during the winter a lot. Howdy. Man, I've been worrying about that since I was a kid. I played soccer, so I got all busted up. Hey, you too. I just want to look at what we're working with today. We've got the ultra cheap micro series Shakespeare, about a 4 foot rod, ultralight with an Ardent reel, ultralight. I've got actually 15 pound braid on it because I break off less that way, but then 4 pound leader. So we're going to float it at a couple different levels and see if we can find something out there. Both the baits are floating power bait. The garlic dough bait style and a little I don't know, with the rubber eggs. Pink sparkle rubber eggs. That's what they're called. Pink scales, sparkle eggs. Floating. Always get the floating because it keeps it up. And then on the other one, I don't know what I'm going to do. This is also ultralight. I really like fishing ultralight. Almost whatever I'm fishing for, but because it makes it feel like a huge fish. Got one. Oh, good. He didn't swallow very far at all. It's hooked like right in the roof of the mouth there. As long as he doesn't jump around too much. Gee willikers. lives to fight another day. Ouch. And I'm gonna not handle him at all. I can. Well, all right. He got me wet this time. Well, I got me wet this time. Let's get in there and cut some more. That's a good one. That's a good one. He's coming home. Yeah, and he swallowed it all the way anyway, so. Makes sense. I'll get that hook back later. I'm gonna string him up and take him home and cook him. I don't always keep fish. You guys have probably seen that. Because it's got the other end. I don't often keep fish, but come catch these stalker trout. I get a good one. He's not huge or anything. He's a good one. Ooh, he's in there. I'll make a nice dinner tonight. I'm happy to take them home now and then. Yay! It's dinner.
Alright. That's enough for one day. Well, it wasn't nearly enough. It's never enough. But I gotta get back home. I got some things to do. We got one good one. We let one go. Got a couple other bites. We're going to go home and cook a fish. Hopefully I can put that on camera too. Or maybe not. I don't know. Anyway. Clean up your trash! Thanks. See you next time.
I see a fish.
Oh yeah, I see a fish too.
Oh, it's so big.
Well, it's not that big, but it's pretty big.
Oh my god. All right.
The first thing I like to do... You want to say hi, Eleanor?
Hi.
Say hi on the camera.
Hi.
Perfect.
Hi.
So the first thing I like to do is wash it so it's not so slippery. Don't move it.
I'm just kidding. Can I have a lemon?
Yeah, well, we're going to cut that lemon. Hang on a sec.
Can I squeeze it in my mouth and it'll make
me
sour in my tummy?
Yeah, it'll make
you
sour.
Oh my god! How can you do it all the way from
the tummy? So, pretty good looking fish today.
Can I pull him?
You want to touch him? Yeah.
Can he talk?
He says, hi, are you going to eat me for dinner?
Yeah.
Meh.
Wait, why did you cut it?
I like to grip him.
Why did you cut it?
What are you doing with a knife?
Hey, it's not off.
Yeah, it's off.
Is that better?
All right, I like to grip him, the gills, because that gives you a good hold there. And then there's this little thin line here. Just jab my knife in, jab my knife out.
Oh my god! You just cut it from the fish!
Cut him starting right at the
god.
Butt there.
Look at that blood. Is that the blood?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh.
You don't have to go very deep. You're just trying to get right. Just trying to get through the skin. Skin and one... thin layer
like,
of muscle there.
It's like your makeup blood.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to touch that blood.
No,
I'll
only rinse it off.
No.
Yeah. Well,
it's disgusting.
And then you grab that little slit you just made.
No, don't show me my mouth. I'm scared.
And you just pull down.
Ugh.
And the whole... You want some milk?
The lemon?
Milk and lemon? No way.
Yeah, it's so good. It's so healthy for me. Let's see what it is.
And then you're left with the blood vein here, so you just put your thumbnail in.
Ugh.
And squeeze it out.
That's so good.
Rinse that off too.
What's that black stuff?
That pretty much all comes out in one piece too.
What's that black stuff?
This is blood.
Oh yeah, I don't like blood.
Left
blood.
Yeah, there's
blood right there.
Yeah, I'll wipe it up.
I'm
gonna give him a good rinse.
Yeah,
all over.
So what do you do next?
Okay, next, we're gonna cut this lemon.
And can I eat it?
Oh, you can eat part of it.
Cut it.
I'm gonna squeeze the lemon. Squeeze the lemon juice right into the cavity of the fish here.
Oh, that's disgusting lemon. That's disgusting with the fish.
And I've got some
can I pour
garlic
it?
Salt here.
Can
you want
to
do it?
It?
You
yeah.
Shake it like this?
Yeah.
Back and forth. Can you do it? Oh, that was a little too much, but that's okay. Just rub it around in there. Mix with the lemon.
Oh, you're keeping your fingers wet. Every time you get it dirty, you gotta wash it every time. I just want to taste that lemon. Can I?
With this lemon?
Yeah.
Okay, do it.
Yeah.
All right, so we got our fish here.
That's really sour.
It's ready to go. Up some aluminum foil and a metal pan. We're going to throw it in the oven. It'll bake for about 20 minutes at 350. Anyway, we'll check back in when that's done.
All right. While your fish is cooking, you get your rice ready. Get it on the plate. Almost. It'll be ready when it beeps. It's about to beep. Get yourself some rice. Vegetables.
I think the hair is really long.
Oh yeah, looking good, looking good.
I think the hair is really long. I think the hair is really, really long. Hey, Daddy, my sister's hair is
ready. Can't touch it.
Can I taste my rice?
Careful. Careful, it's all really hot, baby. It's not quite done.
I love it.
You love it?
It's so good. Where's my cheese?
There you go.
I want cheesy. Can I have my cheese?
You want some cheese?
Yeah.
Have a piece of cheese. Anyway, that wasn't as smooth as it could have been. But that's a nice looking healthy meal. Caught from the world. And this little baby's gonna eat it. You need that whole fish?
No.
No. Here, I'll get you some. Let's go sit at the table. And we'll see you guys next time. Thanks. So man. I almost forgot the last step. There's one more thing you gotta do here. Get yourself a well-prepared glass, nice and cold, a big ice block in it, and pour a bit of a tasty adult beverage in there. And that's for the adults now, not for all the kids. Did you find a bone of yours? Gotta chew carefully. Oh yeah, watch out for bones sometimes. Good job.
Clean up your trash!